Welcome back, students. We were seeing the topic mitosis and the cell cycle. So let's continue our session. The first stage of mitosis is the prophase. In prophase, the nuclear envelope disappears and the chromosome condense. We can see the sister chromatids like this. This is the centromere and the spindle formation is taking place. Now during early prophase, the chromatin network condenses and resolves into the definite number of chromosomes. Initially, each chromosome appears as a single stranded DNA, or you can say long and thin. But as the condensation process takes place, what happens? Each of them becomes an identical sister chromatids like this and held together by the centromere. Throughout the prophase, the chromosome undergo dehydration and coiling to form thick and short. Next stage comes the metaphase. During metaphase, the condensation of chromosome is completed and the thick chromosome get organized along the equatorial plane of the cell. As you can see, they become at the equatorial plane and each chromatin is attached with the spindle with the atmosphere. As you can see, this is the spindle. Now these are the spindles. These are your centromeres. Hence, this stage is called as metaphase. Meta means middle, that and the chromosome lie in the middle of the cell. Now this phase is characterized by the formation of kinetic spindle. These are the spindle fibers. And the spindle is made up of contractile, proteinaceous, chromosomal fibers and interpolar fibers, which is called as mitotic apparatus. Okay. These are the centrioles. These are the centrioles at the polar region. Next phase is the anaphase. Now anaphase is the shortest phase of the mitosis cycle, where the centromeres split into the polar ends and the sister chromatids are pulled apart by the opposite poles of the cell, as you can see here. Now each chromatid is now a separate chromosome. What happens? The kinetic spindle has four types of fibers made up of microtubules. They are astral rays, interpolar fibers, chromosomal fibers and interchromosomal fibers. They all come in the anaphase. Here this is the chromosomal fiber. This is again the continuous fiber. And also the interzonal fibers are also present. Next comes the telophase. Now at the poles, daughter chromosome uncoil and undergo hydration to form the chromatin network. This becomes a cell plate and nuclear envelope reform. Here two nucleuses are developed in one cell and chromosomes also begin to uncoil. Now the nuclear membrane begins to reappear around each group of daughter chromosomes and the daughter nuclei are formed. The spindle fiber disappears. Whatever spindle fibers are there, they disappear, and while the nucleus reappears in each of the newly formed cells. Next comes the cytokinesis. The division of cytoplasm is basically called as cytokinesis. Okay, cytoplasm divides. Now two daughter cells are formed. In animal cells, it occurs by forming of plasma membrane that deepens and the daughter cells. Now as you can see here, this depression is taking place. And after that, finally, the two cells are separated. So students, in this session, we have seen phases of mitosis. First is the prophase. Second is the metaphase. Third is the anaphase. Next is telophase. Then cytokinesis, in which the final cytoplasm division is observed and two daughter cells are separate and formed.